Hi, welcome to another video tutorial from Robojax. In this video, we are going to see how we can use this E18-D80NK obstacle avoidance infrared sensor. So this is the sensor. I've connected it to a buzzer. When it detects an obstacle up to 80 centimeters, it can trigger a switch. So you can use this to in your smart car or any robotic application it detects an obstacle and turn on a motor, relay, switch, whatever you want with this. So you can get the code for this project by clicking at the link in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. So this is the module, the E18-D80NK. So it has two lenses here. One is for transmitter, one is for receiver, does not matter. So, and then we have some wire ring here in case if you're installing it in something that you drill. So you can drill and then put this and tighten it from both sides so it can stay in place. The wiring is very good, it has very strong connectivity. So we have one screw for adjusting the sensitivity, which I'm gonna show you how you do the sensitivity. And this is the light when it detects an obstacle, so the light will go on. The diameter is 17.6 millimeters, so with the ring this is 23.2 millimeters, so the length is 49.5 millimeters. This cable is about 60 centimeters, depending on where you get it. The one that I have is 60 centimeter wire. The device has three wires here. I've connected the brown to 5 volts. This is connected to 5 volts. And then there is another wire, which is blue, connected to the ground, and black, which is a signal out, connected to pin 2. I've connected pin 9 to the buzzer here, to the positive of the buzzer, and then the negative of the buzzer is connected to the ground. So to make clarify here something, this is the one that I'm using now. As you can see, blue is ground, VCC is a brown one, and the signal is a black. If you get another color, which is red, that would be the VCC, ground is black, and yellow is signal. This is a very good way to do it. I don't know why these guys are doing it with this. They have broken the convention, but this is how it is. So. And it should work. And as you can see here, they mentioned 4.7 kilo to 10 kilo, so you can put 1 kilo to up to 20 kilo, no problem. If you're not using pull-up resistor for any reason, you can put that and then connect it. So here is again the diagram. If you're using pull-up resistor, so this is how you do. This is the black, which is goes out. Make sure that the same pin that goes out connected with a 10 kilo ohm resistor to 5 volt DC. Then this will be an independent pin, and it will work if you connect it to pin 2 without the pull-up resistor. But I just avoid this extra wire, and I said in here. In here I said input pull-up. By saying that, I eliminated this resistor. But it's up to you. So if you want to use resistor, this is how it's done. Let me explain the code here. The first thing that we define is pin 2 for the input here, and I call it sensor, and then I define pin 9 for action. So this is the black wire will be connected to pin 2. So after that, so this is the setup. Inside the setup, we just initialize the serial dot begin with 9600 baud, which is used in this screen. And then we set the sensor, which is print 2, as if I type here 2. Input pull up, this is very important. Otherwise you have to put another resistor in on your Arduino board to make it work. So this is very important that you put input underscore pull up. So when you put this pull up, it's as if this pin 2 is connected with a pull-up resistor to the positive. If you're using pull-up resistor, so this is how you do. This is the black, which is goes out. Make sure that the same pin that goes out connected with a 10 kilo ohm resistor to 5 volt DC. Then this will be an independent pin, and it will work if you connect it to pin 2 without the pull-up resistor. But I just avoid this extra wire. Very important, and then action, this is as if I type 9, that 9 is there. So we are saying 9 as an output. So this is the action pin. So inside the loop we say sensor digital read from sensor, and the result will be restored in L. And we say if L is equal 0, this means, because remember we said pull-up resistor is connected to 5 volts, so normally when there is nothing, it will be 5 volts. So when it is 0, actually it detects something. So we say if L is equal 0, which means if value of L is 0, 0 means also low, then we print this text serial.print, and we say obstacle that detected, that this is the text that you see here. And then also we say action high. So this is the pin 9 that I've connected the buzzer, that you hear the sound. So this is a place that you can do whatever you want. You can control a servo to do something. You can switch a motor, change the direction of a motor, stop it. You can turn on a relay, whatever you want. This is a place that you want to do. So either remove this or maybe just press enter and then type your own code when it detects an obstacle. And then we say else. So the else is when there is nothing, no obstacle is detected. So I printed, it says all clear. As you can see, it says all clear. And also we send the pin 9 to low. So this is, in this case, it's connected to the buzzer. So the buzzer will go off. And after that, we wait 500 milliseconds. This is half a second, but if you want this one to go faster, because when it reaches here, this delay just waits, and then it goes back to the loop, and continuously this happens, with the exception of this delay. So if you want this one to go very fast, make this smaller. So 300 milliseconds is approximately about one-third of a second. Or if you make it 100 milliseconds, it will be one-tenth of a second, because 1 second is 1,000 milliseconds. Or if you want it to act slow, just make the 600, 700, or maybe 1 second, which is 1,000, whatever you want. And then the loop continues like that. As you can see here, the sensor is running, and also the code here, it says all clear. I didn't want to show you this code because you just saw it. So we are just looking at this result. And you can also hear the buzzer when it makes buzz. So for you, in order to see it, I just put it close to the table. When I point it to the table, it says obstacle detected. And when I put it up, because the wall is too far, it says clear, all clear. So the pin 9 is now low, and the buzzer is not making any buzz. And interestingly, I've tested this. This works up to 80 centimeters that I did, and which is very true. So you can just change the sensitivity from here. And then also there is an LED will go high. So let me show you. Yes, you can see because this is too far, and when it detects, the light is on. So now let me change the sensitivity. So to change the sensitivity, just you see that it's not detecting. I turned it, rotated right. So to counterclockwise, if I rotate this counterclockwise, it reduces the sensitivity. So you see, this is about 30 centimeters, it doesn't detect. So within 20 centimeters or 25 centimeters, it detects now, because I turned it counterclockwise to the left. Now if I rotate this clockwise to the right, then it will detect at almost, I'm just I'm just going up. This is now about 60 centimeters or more. So let me rotate this until clockwise. So I'm rotating this clockwise. So I'm going back counterclockwise and slowly clockwise. So now it detects. Now if I go a little low, it detects an obstacle. Now at this point it doesn't. So now let me see. There is my hand. Okay, so I hope it's pointing. So here so I'm just reducing the sensitivity. To reduce it, I'm going back counterclockwise. So let me go back clockwise, make sure that it gets. So a little counterclockwise. So now this is not sensitive. So I bring this up, it detects it. Now it's around 40 centimeters. When I bring it down, it doesn't. 45 centimeters. So this is very good. So far this is one of the best ones that I have seen with infrared, except the sharp that measures the distance. So this is very sensitive, and the fact that this works better is because they put a lens here. Thank you for watching. This was introduction to E18-D80NK obstacle avoidance sensor. I definitely recommend this if you're doing robotics project. This is a little large with comparing to the other items, but the quality is amazing. So it works very well with the distance that is needed for majority of the robotics. The only thing that I did not test is the speed or the reaction of this. So please thumb up the video, please share it, and also don't forget to subscribe to get updates of my upcoming videos.
Now it's around 40-45 centimeters. So this is very good. So